Hello everybody, my name is Azukiro and welcome to this video. Today I'm gonna show you more of the basics of Clipstudio Paint from what I learned. So let's get into it. So to begin, we have the basic tool. So I have a little panel that I added. Those are not really important. You can easily remove them by going like on the bin and delete it, because some of them are not very useful. Like you see, I kind of this, like I'm cutting to these two. Sometimes it's not really necessary. So we have the basic tool. So this the G pen, dark pen. I mean the dark pen is quite useful for sketches. You know what you want to do, like little sketches when walking. It's quite useful because it has a bit of transparency. Also there's a mechanical crayons, rough type red, like a lighter design real pencil. All of this is not really necessary for me to tell you how to use, because you learn yourself how to use this tool just by using it, but you'll find eventually. I'm not really here to teach you how to do, I'm here to show you how to use your tool. So when you have GPN looking like this, it's not really necessary for me to show you how I use them, because you'll learn eventually. There are more tools like all paints that I can show you, like a little thing like Madden. I'm drawing this, I have a paint, and it works like actual oil paint. So if you go here, you can actually merge these two together. What I like to do is to reduce the amount of paint, so it merges much easier. Just color strange too. It works easier when you have a really, really big when you have a big when the background is already colored. Like if I have a background that's full of paint, it's easier to use the paint brush, simply because it will merge with the background too. So what I used to do is to I do a little brush here, and it merge easier, and you have this paint style looking. If you are looking for it, that's great. It was just to say that it worked like paint, so you don't have really to get too much into it. To get more, like you can actually add brush by yourself. Like this galaxy brush that I found, pretty cool, I found. And you can add them by going into Clipstudio, Here, you go into your Clipstudio assets, and once you are in Clipstudio assets, you can actually, you have to wait for it to download first. To load, I mean, and once it is loaded, like now I expect, yep, you can actually see some brush. You can look at it, like you have some other brush. You can see the brush on this. Like right now, it's not a brush; it's a material catalog. You have to make different between the brush and the. And I don't know if it's a brush. Don't say it's a brush. It's like work, it's not like product. But you can download it if it's free, because sometimes it's not free. And if it's free, then you just have to go like into this panel. You have all material. So you have the latest brush that you have downloaded, which you can find them only the one you download into your download, but you only have the brush that you have downloaded before. So to get back to the brush itself, you can modify the cork you used, the cork, that was what I'm saying, I'm talking French now, the layer that you are using, like I did in the Galaxy before. You can change the color of the layer. Like imagine I want black. Right now it's in black and white because I use black and white. If I want black and green, for example, I set the second color in green, I have black and green. If I want all green, I know before, and I can reverse this, like have more black and more green. You can change everything you want with this fan. You can do transform it to halftone. It's more useful in manga, but right now I feel like this tool is kind of strange for some reason. Don't have really the halftone style sometimes. Well, at least not in colors. I'll show you another way to use it. And you have border. So border effect, you can just add an edge to your thing. See, like this. So it's laggy because of the halftone. So if I remove the halftone, it looks like this. I can choose the thickness of edges. Show you. I'll show you on something else because it doesn't work really well with kind of brush. If I do a line, imagining I do like a face, if I do a face like this, I can add a border effect. So imagine a black border, I can augment the thickness of the edges, reduce it, match it, yeah. It's like you want, and then you can change its colors again. Once again, I want red, boom, red, more red, give me more red, boom, red. Now this is red, but it's black and red for some reason. It's black and red because of the border effects, it's on red. So if I go back in border effect, but I choose a red border, it becomes all red. So to continue with this, if I go like I'm doing for instance, like I don't know if some of you saw my latest animation loop, I can like for example do a black bluish background. I had like stars on it, stars, galaxy brush. I go on and do like this. Okay, looking all good and everything. I imagine I want some to refine for a bit. I add like some more like into line. Once I have this, I can like choose a layer color. I can go to like imagine I want blue, and then I want some darker blue here. So I have my bluish galaxy. What I can do to make that a little better, like to have the black hole effect, I can go into filter, and in filter you have a lot of effects that is very useful. For example, I use the twirl. Twirl can change the torsion, that can like, but you can see I'm not very good with my English, but what I mean is that it basically twirl your layers. If you do it too much, for example, it will kind of rip sometime if I got too much tension, too large. You can choose, sometime if you want a good effect, it's better to remove tension, to, you can like, change for a bit. You can augment the radius, of course, but if you do it too much, this is what happened. Basically, your layer doesn't follow, it's not big enough, and so it gets ripped off the layer. It's a page, basically you have to think as a page. So if you take for example like this, I want too much of the radius like this. What I can do to correct this is that I can transform, scale, and I can augment the actual thing to where we can't see it anymore. If you don't want to augment the actual thing, then there's another way. It's to actually scale it before doing it like this. It will keep in memory that your layer is bigger than the actual panel, so you can actually move it. And once you have moved it, then you can add with the filter and add like distort, wave effects like this. Like this one, I like this one personally. Feel like it's kind of a glitchy situation. You can modify it. But that wasn't the one I wanted to use to show you. I was on distort wall effects, so it didn't work for some reason. I'm surprised. So let's see what happened. Maybe I'm too much on the side. Yeah. Like I'm right into the center. Not bad. Go into these two effects. If I reduce it a bit. Oh no, that's the radius model. I reduce it a bit. You can have a proper inspiration. It's easy to draw. Oh, my bad. This one for later. This one was for later, so I'll show you that later. So of course you have other kind of filter that I can let you discover because it will be better. You have the noise things and everything. This one is used for some reason. Honestly, I never used it. I know I used it once on After Effects to do some kind of blur effects on like cloud effects. But I don't use it on Clipio. I don't know how to use it. I know there's things to do with it. You have the pinch effect. That's kind of funny to use. Like you can, I don't know, reduce the side. Can choose the radius once again, shape, or you can choose if you want a specified area. If you don't use a specified area, but if you use a specified area, it will do this once again, so it's better to do just the entire selection. So, imagining how I've done all of this and everything, I want to show you something else, like manga I use. I took Clipio. It was like on the advertisement. Like you can do frame, so it's good to use. Like I want frame here, and if I want to cut some frame or to do like kind of, I just did it, so my bad. So if you want to cut frame, you have the divide frame border thing, and you can choose the setting on it here. Like if I want to reduce the side, it's better to do a bit larger because it won't be easy to see else. Imagine I want to cut, I can do this like this. And the big advantage of this is that you can actually draw. It won't get out of the actual manga thing, out of the panel. So of course you can do this on different layers, so you don't have the problem like this. It will only go like this. It's by just doing another layer on top. And then you're doing another frame border, like with the frame border pen that I actually never use because I'm really bad with this. And then you have another layer. that I totally messed up for some reason. But what's wrong with it? Okay. There's you know, there's a glitch sometime where you can't draw out of the layer, so you have to get in, but you can't go on the border actually. But right now I'm trying to draw and doesn't work. To correct this, what I do is that I go onto the frame and I show in the same border, I think, and now it's working. I think, no, not yet. Don't remember the kind of how I do this. No, it doesn't work. I don't use this this layer pen. It's really bad to use. I feel like it. I'd rather use the polyline frame. That works kind of better if you aren't directed to do like this thing. Okay, that was a glitch. I was scared for a second. So right now you can see I can draw on the border. And once I can draw on the border, I'm kind of happy. So to keep going into this, you have actual flash like this that are directly into Clip Studio effects, Clip Studio paint, and you have this other one here on the subtool figures. Like you have this gloom one. I don't use this one because they're kind of strange to use. But I know that if you do like something like this, you can obtain pretty cool effects, like for speed effect and everything. These are some that I use sometimes, like to do the flash things, burst thing. Even for some bubble when the characters are talking, I do use some kind of burst effect sometimes. Well, it takes a long time to load because I use big quality pages. So when it saved, it take a long time. So what I was saying was in burst thing. I want to do a big burst for some reason. And you have the big bursts, and then you're going here and you're doing like something like this. Oh, there's more. Jack it up. So I hold some time. Here. And you can sometimes add a little effect or a little you can add a text sometime on it directly. It's more easier. You have to take in consideration when you're doing a text, it will randomly appear in a frame, and if you don't do anything on it, it will disappear. Even if I go like above, I do a text, it will go back into the frame layer, so it's normal. You have to like write a letter, and then you can drag it above, and the letter will appear above the pages. It's good for onomatopoeia. Well, don't know how to talk anymore. So it's good to use. Once all of this is done, I can remove this and this. I can show you like the blend effect. It's an easy one. It's an easy brush. Like you have like, I'm gonna take a solid one to show better. Like you have this one. You have red on it. And once you have this, you can merge them together with the blend effect. So it will basically blend. All is in the name sometimes. And you have a purple and red. Good. So you have the blur too. Blur work as well. Like, again, it's the name. Or you have the fingertip, that's a classic. If you used Photoshop before, you know it. it's kind of laggy sometimes. I haven't seen on Clipsio the liquify effects. You can see I haven't found it, so it's better to use the fingertips sometimes. What I do is sometimes I even match software, sometimes I go on Photoshop and use the liquify and I come back on Clipsio. Since now you can actually save in a Photoshop document, so it's kind of useful. The auto select tool, a classic. So the selection is really useful. You realize this right now. You can deselect right here and select back now. You can crop, like cut what you want to know, just on the fork you want. You can invert the selected area. You can expand the selected area. So, you know, if I'm going here, I can augment the height. I can reduce it as well. I can delete what's inside. I can delete outside the selection. I can cut and copy. So there's nothing in the other one, but there's only this one. So cut and copy is just like moving around your thing actually, or taking out of a cork of a layer and use it somewhere else. You have the copy and paste. Well, now I have two of them. And then you have the scale rotate, classic. So you can rotate for a bit. You still have the selection, I think, yeah. And you can change like the color inside, you can feel it. Really like it. And then you can do a tone. So tone is really software became useful. You can choose the kind of tone you want. If you want square, if you want circle, I use circle personally. And the angle I like. Man, I messed up. Zero is nice. I can do 75. What did I do? Oh, I know. I just saved 5 clip of the 5 last minutes. Density is great. I can run that. Okay, I go like this. I'm gonna make it like this. Really sick. You can actually choose and then I press OK. And I have the layer filled with pastel. You can of course reduce this tone by doing less density or less actual tone, but I don't want to. Oh, I messed up. So I press 4 and that. You have a tone again that is larger. So you have more the effects of half tone. So now that some of the bass are set, you have the ruler. Okay, never mind. You can read it. The spatial ruler is pretty useful, like for parallel things. Imagine I am doing a spatial ruler. I have my new core, my new layer. I made this. And I want to add like this line, all lines together. It will automatically follow your ruler. So it is really useful to do like structures, architectures. So right now you see a smooth line with a smooth effect. You also have perspective rulers, so This one is kind of tricky, so don't do it twice. You can do actually a perspective world with two points. I don't know how to do it anymore. I think it's in world setting. No, it's not here. I saw a tutorial on YouTube sometime for one day for this. I can't find it right now, so I'm not gonna make my myself over this. So with this ruler, you can actually, as you can see, you can divide it above the back layer, and it will automatically draw from that point you see here. So if I want to do like an architecture again, it will follow the points, and you will still be able to do like a straight line, an horizontal and vertical, but some of the other will follow this point angle of view. So you have to be careful because sometimes it doesn't quite follow. You know, the tool is not perfect, so it only tries to detect what you are doing. As you can see, it's not bad to use it. It's pretty useful for sometimes. For some situation at least. So those are the basic tools. Like I said, you can have your own tool, you just do your palettes sometimes. There's a tool that's kind of, I don't use this one because I feel like it's cheating. You can decide if it's cheating or not, but this tool, for example, I don't like to use it. It's too easy to do with that. I wanted to try something like this, but I don't use that. I feel like it's cheating, honestly, and it's quite kind of bad quality for it's a brush. But another one like this one is better quality, but same. I feel like cheating. If you raise, you have exactly the same building. But if you want to be quick, you can use them. I won't judge. Who am I to judge? So this is something I want to keep for something else. You understand why really soon. So I'm going into this drawing from before, but I made the sketch like yesterday, and I'm gonna show you something really useful. It's a vector layer. So when I do a vector layer, I use my T-Pen because it's really really useful for drawing manga and everything. Because if I do like this, so here she has a horn. So you can see I messed up here and it's kind of out. So when I use a vector eraser and I erased it, it will erase this selection. But if I go on the hard brush, I just erase this, it will only erase this part. But you can change it by using the erase up to intersection or erase the entire the whole line. So it will erase the whole line. So it's best to use obviously the entire selection. But I like to keep one hard brush and one vector brush, so we can use both of them at the same time. You can't, when you're using a vector brush, you can't use the fill tool. As you can see. So what I like to do is like create another brush and I tip on it. So here you have a horn done. So obviously I won't fill it with black because the horns are not really black. But if I keep going on the drawing, you'll see something quite interesting. So what I'll do is that I will do the line of this drawing right now, and I'll get you back afterwards. So, now that that the lines are done, I'm gonna show you some little thing that can be quite useful. So you have this correct line subtool. This is really useful because you can correct the line white or correct the vector line. So show it simply. Now that a vector layer, I can correct like. So I could create the line automatically with that tool, so it looks kind of better, more thin, and it gives the impression that the line is really nice and smooth when it is actually not. Sometimes you just have to remove them and do it again because they don't look quite good. Why is my arcade? That's not the wrong brush. That's the wrong brush. I was like, wait a second. Okay, so this correct line wipe is very useful for line art when you can go and correct line with, like, you can augment, reduce line wipe, scale up, you can control points is really useful when you want to modify something. Imagining I'm gonna modify this little thing here, I can modify the control points. So it look kind of better, we can see. Here we go. We can do that kind of thing. Sometimes it's not really useful because you're gonna do mostly other thing with line, and sometimes it's not really good. But if you don't want to redraw everything, sometimes it's good to correct, because you don't want to have to do this. See? So, this tool can change the line. By the way, if you do another, like, line brush, you can you can merge it to the layer below, and it will still be a vector layer. So as you can see, if I go and back, I can remove it. sea and disappeared. But also, if you do a normal layer, a raster layer, and you do this, you cannot merge them together, because if you do it, it will become a rasterized layer. So you don't want this to happen, so you don't mess with a layer, that's all. So, to come back into the slime. These two, I don't know what they do. I guess I just kind of correct some things. So, what I do, so you have the pinch rectifying things. So if you remember the pinch effect on the dashboard earlier, it's kind of the same, but you can modify that. It's kind of a fluidify effect, but directly on the dwelling. So don't mess up too much with that. It's not a good idea. When you have the connect line life, so you can correct this line together. I don't do it because it's gonna look bad. With the vector line, this one is kind of disturbing. I can't really say what it do because it's kind of strange, so I'm not gonna use it. But the correct line width is something I'm gonna use, because if I want to thicken line like this, for example, and I look back into this razor to remove things I have forgotten. And I'm gonna reduce this side for a bit, remove this, and I'm so gonna augment this so it doesn't look like totally strange. Forgot this, so you can see some details. Sometimes it's really useful to watch closely on the details. And if I want to reduce the vector line, I'm gonna go into narrow. And I'm gonna reduce it. And it's gonna look a little better sometime. If you don't want line to be too straight, too odd, because it's gonna look bad, you can do with this, it's a good way to do. There we go. And I'm gonna just, no, I did too much. Don't overuse the tool like I'm doing, or you'll have to redraw on it after. Sometimes you just have to redraw on it anyway. Here we go. Line art is based with this on this software, it's really useful to do it. Can see, you can augment the shape of the ear, but also reduce it on the other hand. It's kind of useful. So I like to do this and then augment it for a bit somewhere else. So obviously I'm not doing this azartly, so I'm trying to choose which one I'm gonna make larger, which one I'm gonna make thinner. On the way it look, if I don't like how it look, I won't do it, obviously. So what I like to do is thicken the point where the line join together. So it doesn't look like strange things to do. And then I reduce this. Oh no, I'm so stupid. It's a brush side. I was like, oh, why the brush is not changing? Fuck. Yeah, I went kinda speed on the wings this time. No, I like the drawing that you watch from far away. So you can see enlarging line can be quite useful. So still using it gently and doing little by little, not too harsh. Because if you do too harsh, then you use that. Sometimes the line erase because you reduce too much. It's not a big deal, honestly. Sometimes it just look better. So I like to make them disappear sometime. Oh. It's freeing your drawing for a bit. Here I have forgotten something. This. And I can change line white once again. And then I'm going to narrow. I'm gonna reduce it. And that's where you can see some multiple line, and not one line. That's the only problem with vector layers, that's there's like multiple lines, and it's kinda difficult to draw them. There we go. We need to summon the wings. You're surely gonna see me change the things in your wing after, because I don't like when they're not really the way I want them to be. I have some way of drawing the wings that I want to keep. Because god damn, I love wings. Chicken wings too. Oh man, I'm gonna have the vegetarian on me now. What have I done? Well, never mind, it's not a problem. So, I'm gonna augment it for a bit. Not too much, because if they disappear, that's a big problem. Oof, oof. Bitty bit oof, oof, oof. I'm gonna thicken them at some point. Like, which is just a play of white and thin, just changing things sometime. You create a bit of 3D on your drawing, it's looking better. So I like to do it. Forgot the nails, so yeah, best nail hand. I hope I teach you something today. Got nail. Ugh. Oh my god, I have nail. Didn't do it. I'm drawing for how long I'm gonna say some stupid shit like that. When I'm drawing, I'm saying like random things with my head. Don't have to listen sometimes. Just have to take like a deep breath and reflect on why you're existing or something like this. Like, what the fuck am I listening to in this guy? This is done. It's almost done, I mean. Now you can be easier clicking just on this for some time. If you want to turn this side, reset the rotation, change side. Right here I can see the mistake I made, like on the eye. Well, it's not that bad actually. It looked odd, but not too terrible. It looked like she's on this side. Yeah, that's strange. I'm gonna change it by pitching it as a pinch vector line. Remember when I told you the pinch can be quite useful? Look. It's already looking better. So don't forget to use the tool at your advantage. It's not because you draw like on computer that oh my god you're changing. No. If you use a computer, then use it all the way you can. Stuck yourself. And, oh no. This guy is drawing on the computer, he's using it at his advantage. It's cheating! No, it's not. No. Ah, this. Now these eyes look hard on the right. Fuck. So I have to pinch it again. It will be easier for that one. Maybe not. or something. Sometimes there's just too much line. Bothering when we can do this. Okay. So, my back hurts. So bad. Now that I have done this, I can. I can still do it in modify mods. But now that I'm drawing, I can actually do something. I'm gonna first I'm gonna verify if the selection is correct. As you can see now, this part is not considered as a line anymore, so I have to draw on it again. Line again like this. If I'm doing it more, as you can see, it's already better, but there's a little thing like that that I don't want to happen. I'll do this kind of great. What I'm gonna change is one thing. I'm gonna take this and make sure everything is selected. Because I'm gonna show you how to color drawing, like, alright, this is not too much of a problem actually. This is fine for the moment, still fine. Fine, not fine. But this is not too much, I can curve that easily. This, not forget. So, what I'm gonna do, layer. Put the gray, I'm gonna invert the selected layer, fill with gray. You can see the drawing is fully selected. I'm gonna remove the part I don't want to be in here. So there's one mistake I did on the wing, but I'll show you how to correct it. After this, this is actually wrong. So, as you can see, my character is selected. I have only fully corrected, selected it for the form. So, why am I doing this? It is to keep a selection. An easy selection, so you don't have to go and select and save selection and everything like this. I don't even know if it is possible on this thing. And so you have a fully selected character photos. So it will be easier to draw after. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna work with mask. Not gas mask. So first, I'm gonna change the layer color of this. I can change it to a dark purple, like this, and I'm gonna start actually drawing on with him. So what I can do is easy. I can actually select things like this, adding for the eyes, since you don't have a white inside eyes. Yeah. As you can see, there's a little thing that you have to take. So, can expand only by one. Oh. Once this is done, I said once this is done, you can actually add colors again to dark open like this. And I'm gonna show you one thing, is that I'm working with different layer for each colors, because when I do this, I can easily now do this kind of thing. So I can give a 3D aspect without too much effort. As you can see, I'm already feeling the thing. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do like the skin like this. As you have white skin, and when I say white, I really say white. Sometimes you just have to do it yourself, or you can change it by modifying the data layer once again. Yes. That's why you don't close, boy. This is why you don't close. I'm sounding like a creepy old man right now. Hope it's not too disrupting. Wrong. This. I'm gonna select arm, hand, fingers. Make sure all the fingers are selected. And as you can see, there's a little problem here. Like, there shouldn't be gray here. I'm gonna change it just after so you can actually see what it looks like without. But there shouldn't be gray. It's just a misselection. It happened a lot of time. I don't wanna select things, but I have actually corrected me later. Working with a gray background is really useful for that. I'll correct that later, actually. It's not a big deal. White. Like that. And as you can see, there's a problem of selection. I forgot to select this part, and again a mis selection. As you can see under her, it shouldn't be right here. So it's happened a lot of time, you'll get used to it. And I'm back to white. Once the white here, you have to correct the little thing that went a bit overboard. But sometimes it does. And it's not really. Maybe what I can do is just changing the selection a bit so it's smaller. But you'll still have little problem. So for the arm right here, I was going to do this. Ah, wrong. Here you go. I'm going to take the arm. And I'm going to put white, just like that. So all the skin that's appearing is now visible, you can see. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do a new layer. I'm gonna go to clip the layer below. And I'm gonna show you something that can be quite interesting. I'm gonna put this as a reference layer. I'm gonna put like some purple on this arm, some red this one, some blue this one, some green on the head. I'm gonna do something that's called, you might know it already, so it's now at the colorized technology preview. So you have use int image and colorize with more advanced setting colors or F. So I'm gonna try this one. And he did shit because he did nothing. I'm gonna do another one. I'm gonna try the hint and colorize. So it's gonna take a little time. And he tried to colorize once again on the layer. But this tool is a tool that I don't use, because I honestly think that it's not good. It's doing crap, honestly. If I go back and I try another colorize option, it's gonna do shit again. See. He did something wrong, because it's not a good thing to use. Sometimes it works like a glow or something like this, but honestly I wouldn't use it. So you have the RGB things you can choose. I'm not gonna do it, obviously. So I think this is the layer you have to use as a reference layer to use the colorize technology. Forgot to put this, but if you do it, it might change a little things. Oh, never mind, change nothing. So here you go, I want to show you this, but it's crap, so let's not use it. Let's not use that. So I'm gonna show you something more useful. When you want to do shadow, use this layer that I clipped before. And if you want to do give a little volume to your drawing, you can actually add a bit of gray on the side. Do some kind of shadow. What I like to use is some kind of blue, because air blood is blue, so I'm trying to do like a little thing blue. I'm sure you understand that if your skin is white and if you have blue blood, you won't like become red when you're embarrassed or something. You will become blue, because the side is a color of your blood, basically. I'm gonna do it in the face too. So what I'm gonna do on the face is something different. I'm gonna use the selection tool. I'm using the selection tool so it doesn't go on the neck. If it goes on the neck, it's gonna look hard. So then I use it on the face, like this. So I have this, and then what I'm gonna do on the neck is something quite different. I'm gonna select it. And I'm gonna do something direct, because the shadow will be different. X. Sometimes the shadow is not clear, it's kinda blurry and everything, so you don't have to always do like blur, like pencil and everything, or it's gonna look kinda odd. I'm just doing this so it gives a little volume. Like right now I failed. I'm gonna do this. So here the skin is cut off. And I think this is kind of it's for the basics. I don't have a lot of knowledge for FFG because I don't use everything I could use, like this gradient set. Honestly, I don't use it a lot. I could make this now. Can be useful in manga to use this, then can draw on it again. Got the sense set things. This. I by the way, work on the layer too. Just like this. You want to do a rainbow character. Yeah. So yeah, basically this is it. That's not really a dark thing to do, it's not too hard, but those are some of the basics of FFG. Don't forget to save a lot of time, because if you don't, you might lose your file. Imagine the software don't crash often, but it can happen if you have low. Computer that's pretty low. So yeah, anyway, I'm gonna finish the drawing and ask you the at the end. Okay, now it's better. So now I have my drawing that is done. That was quite hard to do. I'm just gonna sign the
later will matter.
Go. And so that would be the end. I hope I showed you a few things just to begin. It's not really hard to use as a software, actually, it's quite easy, so I hope it helps. You can try. Just try what you do. See, there's a lot of things to experiment, you discover a lot actually. And eventually you will do a great job at it. So this is the end of this video. I hope it helped you. And I'll see you next time. See ya.